Good morning, students. How are you all? Okay, so today we are here to start up our second chapter from the part of history. As we had already completed down our first chapter of history, so today we are going to that chapter is actually related with the introduction of history. From that chapter, you came to know about what is actually the history, how we are able to find out the different sources that are present in the history. But in today's chapter, we are going to understand the first phase of our history, that is representing the earliest people. Okay, so here we came to know about the evolution of man, how the man is being gradually developed down, or the different sites, and along with that we will discuss down about the Stone Age and the Rock Art that is present in the ancient India. As we all are aware that it is believed that Earth is over 4600 million years ago old. Okay, so definitely the Earth, and if I talk about the life is possible on Earth on about 3500 million year ago. So definitely, as we all are aware, how is the man that time, as you can able to see in this picture, the human being is like an ape-like creature. Okay, gradually he start developing himself, and the evolution his evolution is took place. So what is actually evolution? The process of development by which human being and various plants and animal evolved over a period of time, how they all started growing up, that is representing to the evolution. So here just one extract is given. So as you all are aware how to complete down the extract, firstly you have to read down the extract, and after reading that you have to attempt the question which is given below. So the first question is, which site is mentioned here? Where is it located? So which site is mentioned here? Definitely you can able to see the heading of the extract as well. Bhim Betka's caves is definitely mentioned here. They can be found southeast of Bhopal in the foothills of Vindhyan Mountains. Okay, the second one is representing what is this place famous for? Definitely this place is famous for the cave paintings. Okay, so if I talk about human being, how is the life of human being, how is the life of the human being in the ancient India, or we can able to say that early human being? So definitely human beings who live about 2 million year ago were nomads. They are known as nomads. They are called nomads, and their main activities what they are doing is hunter and gather. What does that mean? They moved in group from one place to another just to hunt animal, just to hunt fishes, just to hunt birds, and they gather fruit, root, nuts, leaves, seeds, and definitely they migrate from one place to another. Migrate means they move from one place to another in just search of food, water, and shelter. Okay, so how is the life of early human being? Definitely they, what they are doing, they are just living in a groups, and what they are doing, they are just main activity is hunting and gathering. They gather the food just to eat down, and they hunt the animal just to eat down, and whenever they find that the food is empty or no longer in that particular place, so definitely they shift to the any other place. So moving further, now we are going to understand evolution of man, how the man is came into the existence, how the evolution of man, or how man is developed down. Evolution means the gradual development of something. So here we are able to understand how the man is developed down. Like we all are human being, our structure is like, you are all are aware how we look like, but in ancient India the man does not look like. So the gradual process of man is like, as we can able to see in the picture I saw you earlier as well. So what happened at that times, our ancestors representing to the forefather, jo hamare purvaj hai, that is represented by the ancestor. So the body structure of early human evolved over time. An important change of the first human-like creature was the ability to stand on the feet and walk upright. So you can able to see this person is standing on his feet and try to move down or try to move forward. So eventually they no longer supported themselves with the arms to walk. First in the picture you can able to see they are moving like with the feet and the arms as well, like a monkey. You can able to identify or think about monkey, how the monkey moved down. So similarly the human being, as we all know that the human being, it is believed it is just like a monkey. So definitely the structure of human being in ancient India is quite similar to that. Firstly they need a feet and arms to move. After that they think that they can able to move only with the feet as well, so they no longer need a support of arms to walk. Eventually they drop opposable thumbs. This allowed the evolution of man to great object. The brain size increased while their jaw became smaller. Now their brain size starts increasing down and their jaw became smaller down, and finally as you can able to see in the last picture, this type of man came into the resemblance, and that is known as Homo sapiens. Okay, so that is known as Homo sapiens, the human being in the ancient India, which is a particular one, or which is quite similar to in which we are able to see in the present time, is known as Homo sapiens. Okay, so moving further, so the evolution of human being is quite clear to you. So if it is not clear, the diagrammatic presentation is also here, and the name along with the diagrammatic presentation is also written there. And if I talk about the first source which helps scientists to trace the origin of human beings, that is definitely the fossils. So what happens in the ancient India, these fossils are remains and an early plants and animal that were buried under the earth and had hardened with the passage of time. Okay, so this is how we can able to understand, or this is how we can able to know about the human being, early human being or early mankind. So moving further, different sites which is present in the ancient India or ancient world, we can able to say the different sites are definitely such as the things which we found down, tools, weapons, buildings are being found down. So these may found buried under the earth, on the surface of earth, and sometimes even under the water. And most of the sites where early man lived has been found near the source of water. Why the sites representing to the places where the early man lived, and they mostly prefer to live near the water. Why they are preferring to live near the water? The reason behind that is only because water is very much essential for the life, and they too understand that what, how much water is required for the particular survival. So the main two sites are being known at that particular time. That first is representing to the factory site, and the second one is representing to the habitation come factory site. Now what is factory site, what is included in the factory site? Definitely, so the places where early human being made their tools are referred as an factory site. What are factory site? The places where the early human being made their tools. Tools, why they need tools? Definitely for the hunting purpose, they as well need the tools for the cooking, or just for the gathering purpose, or to hunt anything, they definitely need tools. Tools are very much important in the ancient India. So places where early human being made their tools are referred as a factory site. And if I talk about the habitation come factory site, that is representing sites where early human both lived and worked. Both lived and worked are known as habitation come factory site. Factory words is related with the only work, and they found the tools there. And if I talk about habitation, habitation matlab hota hai where we are living, it is representing where we are living. So habitation come factory site representing the site where early human beings or early human both lived and worked as well. Okay, is it clear to you? Moving further, we came to know about the Stone Age. How we came to know about the Stone Age, and what is that Stone Age? like we had already discussed down, the historian is one who search out each and everything that is available in the history. So somehow we tried to find out the about the history, so we came to know about the different stones were present in the history. From there we came to know that there is a period that representing to the stone age as well. So the stone age refers to the period when stone were used to making tools and weapons. Various tools and weapons were made down with the help of stones. Okay, so the early human being used stone to make simple tools for hunting, cutting meats, roots and fruits, and clearing forests. So these are the main activity which is being done by the ancient people, or which is being done by our forefathers, or we can able to say our early humans, that they use stone to just to make a tools for hunting purpose, cutting meat, roots, fruits and clearing forest. Okay, so moving further, the bones, animal horns and piece of wood were used for making these tools. Okay, so moving further, the stone age is divided into three types. So what are those three types, or we can able to say the stone age is divided into three ages. The first age is representing to the Paleolithic age, and the second age is representing to the Mesolithic age, and the third one is representing to the Neolithic age. So definitely the Paleolithic age is further divided into three parts. The first is representing, because Paleolithic age is considered as a longest age or a longest period, because it extended lot many of time. So that is the reason the age is further divided into three parts. The first is representing to the lower Paleolithic age, the second one is middle Paleolithic age, and the third one is representing the upper Paleolithic age. So definitely the word Paleolithic age, or the old stone, and from where the word Paleolithic is came, the word Paleolithic is came for the combination of Greek words, that is paleo. Paleo means old, and if I talk about lithic, lithic is representing to the stone. Okay, paleo means old, and if lithic is representing to the stone. And if I talk about Mesolithic age, Mesolithic means, meso means middle, and if I talk about Neolithic age, neo means new. So lithic is definitely, you all are aware, it is came from the Greek word, and that means stone. Okay, so there is few question that we had to discuss down once, so let us check it out once. What is meant by the term evolution? So what is the meaning of term evolution? Process of development by which human being and various plants and animal evolved over a period of time, that is representing to the evolution. Okay, the second one is, what are fossils? So what are fossils? Old hardened remains of plants and animal that lie buried under earth for long time, representing to the fossils. Okay, so I'm repeating it once again. Old hardened remains of plant and animal that lie buried under earth for long time is representing to the fossil, or is called fossils. Okay, what is meant by the term nomads? So what are nomads? Nomads are the people who move from one place to another, to just because they don't have a permanent or fixed place, they just move from around one place to another in search of food. So nomads are such kind of peoples. So moving further, what is stone age? We had already discussed down, the stone age refers to the period when stones was used for making tools and weapons. Is it clear to you? So moving further, now we are going to start up the Paleolithic age. The Paleolithic age is also known as old stone age, and definitely we had already discussed down, the word Paleolithic is the combination of Greek word. What are those Greek word? Paleo means old, and lithic is representing to the stone. And the discovery of this particular age is being done by the Robert Bruce in 1863. Okay, so who find out about this place is definitely the Robert Bruce. Okay, so what happened in this particular age, human being used tools for huntings. They just hunt, these hunters gathered, moved from place to place in search of food, water and shelters, and the people of in this particular age lived in caves out in open or the tree tops or rock shelters. So definitely they survived by hunting, because their survival is completely dependent on the hunting. Without hunting, the survival is not possible for there, because they don't know how to cook the food, they don't know about the grains, they don't know about the things any like we are aware in present time period. So what they did, they just hunt, and their main survival thing is just is hunting. Okay, so they survived by hunting animal, birds and fishing, and by gathering fruits, nuts, leaves and stalks. So definitely they lived in a group. Why they lived in a group? Because whenever we are in a group, it is quite easy for us to hunt a big animal. So that is the reason they prefer to live in a group. They lived in a group as it helped them to hunt large animals and to share food. It provides security and against the dangers. Why it provides security against the danger? So definitely you can able to understand with your group as well. Na? If you are only one person there and if you try to hunt any animal, it is quite difficult for you. But if I talk about a particular group, you have a group of 10 to 15 people and you collectively go to hunt any animal, that is more safer and quite convenient for you. So this theory is also being used by the people in the Paleolithic age. So Paleolithic age, as I told you earlier as well, is the longest period of Stone Age, because it appears or it started down from the artifacts 2 million years ago. It started from the 2 million years ago. You can able to understand how much long concept this is, and ended last ice age about 10,000 years ago. And further, this is divided into three parts. The first is representing to the lower Paleolithic age, that is known as a emergence of hand axe industries, and the second one is representing to the middle Paleolithic age, the era of Neanderthal, and the third one is representing to the upper Paleolithic age, or that is known as Homo sapiens. Okay, so what we discussed down in the Paleolithic age, the main thing that you have to recall about this, from which the word combination, the Paleolithic word, right, it is from the Greek word, that is paleo means old, lithic is representing to the stone. And who discovered this age? This age is being discovered by the Robert Bruns in 1863. Okay, so the human use big stone for hunting. Their food is what they get from hunting. Believe in nature and natural forces, and they also have a fear of nature. Always remember, in the Paleolithic age, the human being has a fear of nature, because they are unaware. Na, suddenly when it starts raining, they started feeling fear because they are unaware about the rain. Okay, so even in the Paleolithic age, I'll taught you one more thing. The goddess statue was found in Allahabad. From there we came to know that the people who are living in the Paleolithic age are worshipping or praying to the god as well. They have a belief in the god as well. Even the people who is living in the Paleolithic age has the belief on god as well. So moving further, the next we came to understand about the sites which is there in the Paleolithic age, or we can able to say the Paleolithic site. Paleolithic sites means लोग जहाँ पे रह रहे थे. Okay, so the names of sites are like Portwork Plateau is there, Narmada Valley is there, Son Valley is there, Chota Nagpur Plateau is there, Plateau in Jharkhand, Shivalik Hill, Adam Hills near Narmada MP, Bhimbetka in MP, all such are the sites which are available in the Paleolithic age, which we came to know about in the Paleolithic age. Because as we discussed down, have you noticed now most of the sites are near the river. Why they are near the river? Because we had already discussed down the early human beings, or the human being that is living in the ancient India, preferred to live their, or preferred to choose their survival near the river. Okay, so moving further, the another sites that are present there, the Deccan region of India, definitely Pune, Nasik, Chirinivasa, Maharashtra, Kurnool in Andhra Pradesh, Hansgi in Karnataka. So the sites that is located in fertile plain, fertile hote raje upjau. Okay, so you always heard na that soil is more fertile than the any other one, because वहाँ पे हम क्या है बहुत अच्छी crop grow कर सकते हैं. So the fertile plains are there, Tapi, Krishna, Godavari, because these three, you all are aware, are rivers, and we had already discussed down the people prefer to live there where there is river near, because the water is essential for the life, and they too came to know about this. So the various tools which is being used by the people of the Paleolithic age is representing to the, so definitely we had already discussed down the main work is just to hunt things and eat them. They use various kind of tools, just for cutting the meat, just for cutting the bones, sharp barks, trees, just to cut down the sharp barks from the trees, hide from the animals, chopping for the fruits and roots. So definitely they need tools as well, na? So there are two kinds of tools which is being used by the early human being. The first is representing to the core tool, and the second one is representing to the flake tools. So what is core tool? Core tools were made by chipping off pieces or chunks of rocks or pebbles. So you can able to see, so some kinds of core tools are already drawn here. So you can able to see it is made up of pebbles. Pebbles is representing to pathar. Okay, so pebbles are representing that. So the core tools were made by chipping of piece from chunks of rocks and pebbles. These are being made out from the pebbles. So moving further, we can able to understand about the flake tools. So what are flake tools? Flake tools were made from the sharp piece of flakes that broke off while the core tool. Now they are making the core tool, and suddenly flake tool or a sharp piece of flakes broke down. From that they make down the flake tool, and they use these kind of tools for their hunting purposes, or just for the cutting of meats and other things. Even a flake tool of stone that was to be shaped as a tool was placed on the harder surface, and pointed piece of wood, stone or wood was placed on its chisel. Okay, then another piece of stone was used as a hammer to give it desired shape, and flake tools were made for chopping meat and skinning animal. So definitely if I found pebble, it is not like na that is my tool, I have to shape it by myself. If I won't shape it properly, that pebble is not being converted into the tool. Similarly, if they found a flakes that broke off from the core tool, it is not possible they are directly able to use that. So definitely they have to shape them, and after shaping them they are free to use them. So you can able to see in the picture how the flake tools look like and why they use it for the chopping of meat and for skinning the animal. Okay, is it clear to you? So moving further, we came to know about the discovery of fire. We use the fire in the cooking as well, in heating as well things. So from where the discovery of fire has came in the existence? Have you ever thought down from where the fire came to existence? Who tell us about the fire? How we know that the fire is useful for the cooking? How we know that the fire has the capacity to burn things? So definitely we are going to discuss about the discovery of fire, how that fire is came into the existence. So let us start.
So from where the fire is being discovered down, so it is not like a planned discovery. No planning was there, just it is considered as a accidental discovery. How it is considered as an accidental discovery? Because it is traced down that in the Paleolithic age, what happened? They rubbed the two pieces of the wood or stone and suddenly the fire broke out from that. And they used the fire in cooking meat and in scaring of the wild animal, provide light at night and keep warm in the winter. So it is not like that they have planned something and after that the fire came into existence or they done a lot of experiment on that. It is considered as a very much accidental discovery. They just rubbed the two stones together. If you remember, if you have heard that in the ancient India, the fire is being produced by the people by rubbing the stones. The two stones they take down and start rubbing them and suddenly the fire broke out from those stones. And how they use that fire? They use a fire for the cooking purposes, for providing light at the night and for keeping warm themselves in the winter. And even they use that light and use that fire to scare the animals. Scare hote raje darana. Okay, so they just use that fire to scare wild animals. So is it clear to you? So what we had discussed down in the Paleolithic age, we came to know that the various kinds of things that are available in the Paleolithic age, the human being used big stones for the hunting. Their food is whatsoever they hunt from the forest, and they have a strong belief in the nature and the natural forces. Even they had we found a mother goddess statues in the Allahabad. From there we came to know that they have a belief in the god as well, and this age is being discovered by the Robert Bruce. And various Paleolithic further the Paleolithic site is divided into three parts: the lower Paleolithic age, middle Paleolithic age and the upper Paleolithic age. And upper Paleolithic age is the only modern Homo sapiens are known to have existed. This is still existing down and it is believed down because it is a upper Paleolithic representing that a complete formation of human being is being done. So definitely the human being is existed in the present time period as well. So moving further, we came to know about the different Paleolithic site. Here we notice one thing, that each and every site is near the river. So there is a case study of Hunsi Valley is given, so you have to read it by yourself. Okay, so moving further, we had discussed down the various tools which is being used in the Paleolithic age. So definitely they use chopper, chopping hand, egg cleavers, the flakes, and the main two types of tools are core tools and the flake tools. So for core tools, we had already discussed down that is being made from the pebbles, and the flake tools representing to the sharp pieces of flakes that broke down while the making of core tools. Okay, further we came to know about the discovery of fire is being done in the Paleolithic age, and it is not a planned discovery. Definitely this one is considered as an accidental discovery. So here are few questions that you have to answer. So let us discuss that once. What are factory sites? So definitely the factory sites are the places where early human being made their tools are referred to as a factory site, or referred to as a factory site. Okay, so the second question is representing what are habitation cum factory sites, sites where early human being both lived and worked are known as habitation cum factory site. We had already discussed these two questions in the extract as well. So for moving further in the paragraph, we had discussed it. So moving further, what is Paleolithic age? What is the Paleolithic age? We had already discussed here. The Paleolithic age was the longest period of Stone Age. It extended from the first appearance of artifacts around 200 million years ago and the end of the last ice age. Okay. So who discovered the Paleolithic age? If I talk about, then it is Robert Bruce. Okay, moving further, the next is representing what are core tools. So core tools are definitely made by chipping off piece from the chunks of rocks or pebbles. So moving further, the next is representing what are flake tools. So what are flake tools? Definitely the flake tools are made from the sharp pieces or flakes that broke off while making core tools. Okay, is it clear to you? So moving further, now we are going to start up our second age, that is representing to the Mesolithic age. So what is included in the Mesolithic age? As Mesolithic age falls between the end of last ice age and the beginning of agriculture, because the Paleolithic age continued till the last ice age. So Mesolithic age falls between the end of last ice age and the beginning of agriculture, and agriculture is being practiced down in the present time period. Okay, so moving further, so what is included in the Mesolithic age? So Mesolithic people lived by hunting, gathering and fishing. While older tools were still in use, human being learned to have better tools during this period. A Mesolithic age saw the introduction of different kind of tools called microliths. So what happened in this time period? So Mesolithic people definitely they do spend their life by hunting and gathering and fishing. Okay, so as we had already discussed down in the Paleolithic age, there is availability of stones as well, in the tools as well. They found down the tools, the core tool was there, flake tool was there. So definitely the Mesolithic people use those tools as well, but along with the dart tool they introduced the different kinds of tools too. So that is known as the microlith. Microliths were usually small stone tool fixed on the handles of bone or wood, or to make tools such as spears, arrows and saws. So these are called microliths. So these are being used by them. So what is being done by the people? Gradually the people begins using wild grains as a food, and they started domesticating animal. Domesticating animals means ki unhone animals ko palna shuru kar diya, apne gharon mein rakhna shuru kar diya. If I talk about the Paleolithic age, they just only hunt down the animal and start eating that. But the Mesolithic age is quite mature age from the Paleolithic one. So instead of only hunting, they use hunting and gathering activities as well, but they are not going on only with the hunting practices. They too start domesticating the animals, they too start eating the grains as well. By the end of the Mesolithic age, human being seems to moving towards a more settled life. Now they start settling down their life, and whenever we found the end of Mesolithic age, definitely a well settled life is being found down, which is by the human being. So various sites which are there in the Mesolithic age, sites is representing to the jaga, okay, or bigger area. I think we had already discussed in the Paleolithic age as well. So various sites that are present there are definitely Gujarat, Chota Nagpur, Jharkhand, Rock settlers of Bhimbetka and Adamgarh. Okay, so sites along the rivers are Ganga between the Ghaziapur and Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh, Bagor and Mysore. So you just have to read down the names of the site. No proper explanation for this site is possible, because these are the name of places which is found in the Mesolithic age. So definitely you just have to read it once and recall it, which sites are there in the Paleolithic age and which sites are there which we found in the Mesolithic age. Moving further, now we came to know about the rock art. So rock art is definitely representing. So what is actually rock art? Rock art refers to the painting made by the early humans on the walls of caves. So the people start living in the caves. Caves is representing to the gufa. Okay, so the people start living in the cave. So the people start living in the caves. So in caves they did the painting. They made a lot of paintings there that gives us idea about the various human beings of that particular time period. Okay, the so paintings mainly portrayed animal figures, and these paintings are mainly shown as an animal structures or animal figures. If I talk about the several paintings has been discovered at the Bheem Betka caves, that is in the Madhya Pradesh. We came to know from that particular cave about these Mesolithic sites and Mesolithic age a lot, because the people made a lot of paintings there that gives us lot of hints about that. So definitely birds, fish, crabs, frogs, scorpions are also painted there. Some painting shows that men and women, two colors were made from the rocks and naturally available minerals, and mainly the two colors which is being shown there are red and white, which is being used by the people at that time period. Okay, so what is included in the Mesolithic age? Mesolithic age falls between the end of the last ice age and the beginning of the agriculture. Further, we came to know about the Mesolithic sites, and along with that we came to know about the rock art. So here is one brainstorm that you have to answer. A lot of rock art paintings depict animal either as plant or hunting scenes of separately. Why do you think the early human being made such painting? So definitely early human may have made such painting depicting mainly animals on the ceremonial occasions or perhaps for the special rituals. It is just kind of assumption. Now we are not sure why these paintings are being made by the early human being. So we are just giving the assumption that it might possible they have made for the ceremonial occasions or just for the special rituals. Rituals is representing to the rasm rivaj. Okay, so that is depicting the rituals. So the next is given, you have to answer these question. What is Mesolithic age? So what is Mesolithic age? So Mesolithic age falls between the end of the last ice age and the beginning of the agriculture, and it is also known as period of transitions. Okay, transition mean change hona kisi cheez ka. So moving further, what is microliths? Microliths is representing to the here. So microliths were usually small stone tools fixed on the handle of bones or wood to make tools such as spears, arrows and saws. So moving further, the third one is, what is rock art? So rock art refers to the painting made by the early humans on the walls or cave. Okay, so moving further, the fourth one is, which colors were used most of the rock art? Definitely the mainly color was used there, we had already discussed down. The two main colors are there, that is representing the red and white. So here a picture is also there. Which scene is depicting in this picture? Definitely what you can able to see, a man is there, animal is there, so a man taking an animal along with him. So which colors were used there? Mainly you can able to see a red and black was there, which is mostly used in this picture. Okay, so hope you are clear with this chapter. What we had discussed down in this chapter, we came to know about the earliest people, how the people are living in the ancient India. Further, we came to know about the evolution of man, how the man came into existence, or in present time period, or the last man is considered as a Homo sapiens. And further, we came to know about the different sites. Along with that, we came to know about factory site and the habitation cum factory site. Further, we understand the concept of Stone Age. And in Stone Age, this further Stone Age is divided into three parts: the Paleolithic Age, Mesolithic Age, and Neolithic Age. And further, Paleolithic age is divided into three parts: Lower Paleolithic Age, Middle Paleolithic Age, and the Upper Paleolithic Age. Further, we came to know about the various tools that is used in the Paleolithic Age, and it is mainly consist of the two that representing to the core tools and the flake tools. And discovery of fire is being done in the Paleolithic Age. If I talk about the Mesolithic Age, Mesolithic Age falls between the end land of the last ice age and the beginning of the agriculture, and various Mesolithic sites are available there, or we are able to find out there. And the main activity which is being done by the Mesolithic people are definitely hunting, gathering and fishing as well. And further we came to know about the rock art. So rock art refers to the painting made by the early humans on the walls of caves, and these paintings help us to know about the whole history. Okay, so from these paintings we came to know about lot of things, and main colors which is being used by them is red and white. And how they made these colors are being made from the rocks or the natural minerals which are available to them at that particular time period. So hope you all are clear with the chapter. So now your homework is, after watching this video, you have to read down the chapter thoroughly from your book, and after reading the chapter, complete down the exercise which is given at the end of the chapter, and try to solve this exercise by yourself without the help of any other person.